Hello everyone, very good afternoon. Let's start this webinar talking about how eMagical can help clients to enrich their Microsoft Teams with our application suite. Today we'll be in this webinar myself, Anas. I'm the channel manager in the Middle East, based in Dubai. With me as well, Andrea Sonino, our senior technical solution specialist, joining us from Italy. Very good morning, Andrea.
Hello, good day, everybody. Thanks for joining.
Thank you, Andrea. So excited to start this topic. Let me, guys, just give you a brief introduction about eMagical for those who don't know who we are. We are a company of 100 people distributed across three continents in six offices worldwide. Here in the Middle East, we have an office in Dubai. We have another office in Riyadh in Saudi Arabia with a full operation team. The same in Europe. We have in three offices in Italy, and we have a team as well residing in France, and we have our colleagues in the US covering the North America. We have clients and partners across more than 150 countries. We work with more than 350 channels worldwide, and with several service providers. Today, we are talking about the same application suite that you know, that we use to integrate with the call manager. We are talking about the same feature, the same application suite you loved, how our applications can be integrated and enrich the Microsoft Teams. We'll be talking as well about the artificial intelligence and the digital conversational experience that we are providing with this application suite to simplify the deployment, the integration, and then very easy to administrate and to manage. Our applications are ideal for mid-market and enterprise. So they are available in the cloud for clients using Microsoft Teams. They are available as well with mixed environments or for clients who are still on-prem and moving to the cloud with their own piece. How we are providing our cloud services, eMagical as a service. We are leveraging on the data centers of Amazon. Amazon is the one of the leaders of cloud providers. So they have many data centers across the globe, here in the Middle East, in Europe, in North America. We can as well provide our clients a POC from those data centers, so they can try, test the solution, make sure that this is exactly what they need before moving on and purchase our solutions. We are providing as well a dedicated cloud instance that can be activated over more than 20 data centers around the world, leveraging, as I said, through the data centers of Amazon. We take care in eMagical, and we understand very well the concerns of our client when we talk about cloud. They always share some risks or concerns. The first one is the physical security. And this is why we selected Amazon Web Services data centers, because working with Amazon means that we are working with the top level security of a leading cloud provider. This is why we decided to go with Amazon, to provide our clients and our partners the top possible security. The product security, our developers, when they start building the application, making the code, the first thing they think about and they follow is this secure software development lifecycle approach, making sure we address all the security possible gaps, providing a very solid and secure application suite. We as eMagical as well, we have invested with WASP. We are certified from WASP, which is the organization that shares the top 10 top known vulnerabilities. So we do the penetration test and make sure that we address all of those vulnerabilities. And the most important thing may be the privacy of the data, where we comply with the international regulations like HIPAA, like GDPR, and the rest of international regulations. All the services you need with eMagical, as we said, that we have full operation office across the three continents. So we have the support team, not providing the support to the clients overseas, but from the local or regional offices, our advanced services that you work with, and most of you guys have the experience with them, they will be as well working and supporting our clients. We have, as of today, many stories to tell of clients using Microsoft Teams of Imagical. So it's not something that we are just launching up today. We worked during the past few months. We have already the experience and the use cases to share with you for clients around the globe using Imagical with Microsoft Teams. Andrea, we want you now to take us through a journey about the applications.
Absolutely, no problem. If you grant me the share, I will share my screen. Thank you. And here we go. Okay, let me resume the presentation. Great. So Anas already explained to you that what we are providing here is a suite of several applications running from our cloud and fully integrated with Microsoft Teams environment. Now, let's see more in detail what we can provide actually through our UC Cloud Suite. The first thing that I want to share with you is the fact that we got this unique integration with the actual client that is using Microsoft Teams. Okay, as you can see, within the Microsoft Teams clients, we can provide three applications, okay, which are directly accessible from the client itself. First one is the call recording to access to the list of recordings, the digital fax, you know, to send the fax and access to the fax inbox and outbox, and the contact manager, which allows you to access to the corporate directors of internal and external contact. This is really a unique feature that we are providing to our customer. And this is already included by default into our UC suite, so no need to pay any extra fee to get those gadgets. Okay, but now let's talk a little bit more about the application. Okay, the first one, very important, is the attendance console. Okay, so we're providing an attendance console to the Microsoft Teams operators or Microsoft Teams agents, which can fully control their queuing application. They can answer call, they can access to the directory. And this attendance console, it's native integrated with Microsoft Teams. That means that can be used in any type of PSTN access. So if you decide to use the dial plans provided directly by Microsoft, or if you decide to use a local PSTN access by using the direct routing Microsoft model, okay, that's not a problem for us. We are completely independent for this. Please bear in mind that the Imagical Attendant Console is working together with the Imagical Advanced Queuing and Imagical Auto Attendant. Advanced Queuing is the application which allows you to enqueue the incoming calls and distribute them to one or multiple operators. And the auto attendant is our IVR application. Okay. But once again, we are using our own queuing and our own IVR. So we are not leveraging the native call queuing and the native auto attendant available in Microsoft Teams. You can ask me why. That's very simple, because through our application, we can provide lots of report and real-time data, okay, which would normally not available by using the native call queuing and native auto attendant coming from Microsoft Teams. And that's a very good reason, but I will show you later on about this. I'm also glad to inform you that we can provide the attendant console together with different type of soft phone application, all right? Okay, so you can decide to leverage the Imagical Attendant Console together with your standard Microsoft Teams client. Okay, so basically you will have your workstation with the Attendant Console installed and the Microsoft Teams installed. And from that workstation, you can handle all the incoming calls for the company. But we are also providing another alternative, which is very interesting, because don't forget that many people are migrating to Microsoft Teams coming maybe from a legacy platform. I don't know, maybe from an Avaya PBX or from a Mitel, whatever, okay? And maybe they are used to use the Attendant Console together with a physical phone, together with a desk phone. So with Imagical, we have this exclusive solution, which can be used together with a physical phone, okay? And not only this, if you're going to use a physical phone, we can also provide additional features which are not available from Microsoft Teams when you use Microsoft Teams client. Due to the fact with Microsoft Teams, we're using API. And those API coming from Microsoft are still under tuning. Okay, so they're not still perfect. Okay, so some feature like park resume, campaign calls are actually currently not available with Microsoft Teams, but they are currently right now available if you're going to use a physical phone. When we talk about physical phone, we are talking about Poly, SIP phones, okay, and also Yealink is coming soon. And those SIP phones are registered to Microsoft SIP Gateway. Okay, so they are standard SIP phone registered to Microsoft Teams. We have no problem to control them from the Athena console client. Just for your information, that the Magical Athena console client is available in three different flavors. Okay. What we normally suggest, of course, is to use the fully featured Athena console, which is called the Athena console enterprise version, okay, which is including all the different panels for the queues, for the agent, for the supervisor as well, okay, and it allows you also to log in and log out to specific queues, etc. The problem is that the enterprise version is not suitable for operator with visual problem, okay, like short-sighted operator or blind operator. And in that case, we can offer our professional version, which can be used together with our desk phone solution, okay, by using Poly. And this is absolutely compatible and compliant for those type of visual impaired operators. The third option is the Operator Essential, which is a very, very much simplified version of the Magical Athena console, with some reduced features, some reduced panel to access, but can be fine for, you know, like agent answering in a call center, for example, which does not need a sophisticated and maybe sometimes complicated Athena console client. Okay, let's jump to the next application included into the Magical UC Cloud Suite for Microsoft Teams, which is the call recording. Once again, here we are providing a native integration with the Microsoft Teams environment. That means by leveraging the Graph API from Microsoft, we can enable Microsoft Teams user to record all their calls, both internal, external, incoming, and outgoing. And this is done in always on mode. Okay, so basically all the calls are automatically recorded without any user intervention. Once all the calls have been recorded and saved in the Magical server, we can provide access to them by using the gadget, as you can see in this screen. So you have the list of all the recording and you can listen to it, or from the Magical web portal, which is giving a richer experience. Okay, so just to summarize the feature, as I say, record internal and external code in always on mode. Okay, call recording awareness, this is very important. So the caller is informed about this. We can play announcements. We can provide a search and play web portal from which you can search, you can browse the list of all the recording and listen to them. We are providing the possibility to add notes to each recording. So if you want to remember what was the topic of the conversation without having to listen to the conversation, you can just add a note on it so that you can easily find it across the list of all your recordings, because those notes are searchable as well. We are providing reporting. Okay, so if you want to evaluate the volume of calls which are recorded by each operator, we are providing those reports, which are exportable as a PDF, Excel, or Word, and also schedulable if you want to receive it automatically on your email address. And last but not least, the app for Microsoft Teams, which is the gadget that I previously explained to you. What's boiling in the pan? Okay, these are some additional functionality that we're going to enable very soon. Okay, first of all, on-demand recording, so the possibility to start and stop the recording directly from the client. Live keep, again similar to the on-demand, which means you have a start button available on the client, and if you press the start button even in the middle of the conversation, we are going to keep the whole content of the conversation, not only from the moment you press the button. The integration with Athena console, so we're going to provide the buttons to start, stop, and pause, resume the recording directly from the Athena console client, which currently is not available. And later on, the recording filters to record only incoming or only outbound, etc. I'm sure you are aware that nowadays we are launching a new service, again coming from our cloud, which is the Magical Voice Analytics. This is a service very tied to our call recording. Basically, if you're going to enable this new application, then we are going to allow you to transcribe the content of your recorded conversation, which means every time a new recording is saved into the Magical UC Cloud Suite, the same content is also uploaded into the voice analytics you will find in the list of all the recording, like in the screenshot we are showing here. And by clicking on each of those recordings, you have the possibility to browse the whole transcription of the conversation. So you will see the two parties, the local party, the remote party, and then you can say, you can actually read what they're saying each other, like, hello, how are you? What's your problem, et cetera, et cetera. But not only this, other than transcribing the context of the conversation, we are also applying an artificial intelligence algorithm to detect the mood of the conversation. Okay, so, you know, by analyzing the cadence, you know, the way that people are speaking, our artificial intelligence algorithm can detect if the party is happy, if it's neutral, or if it's angry, you know, not happy. Okay, so these three, let's say, icons are shown directly on this portal, and you can have an overall evaluation of the conversation, of the mood of the conversation, but you can also see the mood on each conversation leg. Okay, so in any moment you can see what is the mood of the calling or the called party. The next application that we are providing for Microsoft Teams environment is the Contact Manager. This is very, very important because through this application, you have the possibility to import and synchronize any type of contact, both internal and external contacts. And once all those contacts are consolidated within the Magical Server, we are providing access directly from the Microsoft Teams client with the possibility to search across all directory or to search within specific directory. Or we are providing the access from the Magical Attendant Console, and we're going to see that how important it is for this purpose. Other than this, we are providing also caller ID. So if you're going to receive a call coming from our queue, from our advanced queuing application, and the call is then transferred to the agent, the agent will see the caller name. So we see the name, the surname, and the company name. Of course, if the calling party is included into our directory. So we're going to look up name, surname, and company name and show it on the Microsoft Teams client, on the pop-up, and also on the Attendant Console. Again, we are going to see that during the demo. Next application, Digital Fax. You know, Fax Server is still up and running, it's still alive and kicking, and many, many people, especially in the public administration, in the finance environment, are still requesting to have a fax application, right? Well, this is our totally 100% software-based application, which allows you to send and receive faxes. How you do that? You can do that in different ways. You can do that from the Microsoft Teams client, okay, thanks to our embedded gadget. You can do that from the web portal. You can do that from your email client. Okay, so if you have like an Office 365 account, etc., you have the possibility to send a fax directly from your email and then from other media that are available. Well, I think you are tired of listening to my voice and listen to my slides. So let's have a live demo. So let's see what we are talking about. Very good. Okay, so this is just for your information, our web portal, which every user can access, you know, to browse the recording, to access to their list of fax, the call analytics, etc. But most important, what I want to show you is our gadget. Okay, so this is my Microsoft Teams client. Don't forget that I'm a smart worker. So I'm working from home together with my Microsoft Teams on my PC and together with the Magical Attendant Console. Okay, so I'm fully fitted to do whatever I want from home. Okay, first gadget I want to show you is the call recording. Okay, so here you can see the recording that I have performed. You can actually search across different users, different phone numbers from specific time interval. You can also search by note, etc. And once you have found the recording you need, of course, you have the possibility to listen to it. So if I just click any of those recordings, I get a player. Okay, so no need to download the recording on my PC and open a Windows Media Player or QuickTime, whatever. No, I just listen to here. I just click play and here we go. I can hear the conversation on my PC screen. That's very nice. If I want, I can grab also more details about the conversation, about the date, time, the duration of the call direction, the recording ID. I can here add a note, okay? Important call, for example. And this note will be saved and will be searchable across all my recording. And most important, I have the possibility to download the content of this conversation as a standard MP3 file directly into my PC. Of course, this is available only if my administrator allows me to do that. Otherwise, I can only listen to it, but not download it, right? Great. Let's go to the next gadget, Contact Manager. As I say, with Contact Manager, you have access to all your corporate directory, including internal and external contacts, okay? Here you can see the directory where I have granted the access. Okay, so the directory to which I'm interested, and I can search. So I can search across all the directories. So I can just type a few letters like Rob, for example. And this is going to search across many thousands of users, I can tell you. And the search is very quick. Okay. So the system has picked up for me a list of contacts. Okay. All of them included this Rob. And for each contact, I have telephone numbers. Okay, I can have multiple telephone numbers actually associated, like maybe home phone, mobile phone, office phone, etc. And once I have found the contact I need, I can just click to call. Okay, so from here I can just click and the call will be triggered directly on the Microsoft Teams client. Very, very useful. Otherwise, if I want, I can just go inside the specific directory. I don't know, for example, I can go inside this directory, which is including 40,000, and then just or scroll the list. Okay, which is pretty long, or just search within this specific directory and find only the contact included into this directory. But the next one is digital fax. So with digital fax gadget, I have the possibility to send a fax, first of all. Let's wait. So I have available a fax wizard. So from here, I can just select this. And I can just start sending fax. So I can select recipient, first of all. So I can search by name, for example. Okay, I want to send to this guy. Then I want to send to, I don't know, Andrea something. Then I want to say to this guy. Okay, it's going to pick up the fax number related to those contacts. Then I can add the subject. I don't know, your invoice, for example. I can select the cover page because we also support multiple cover pages within our system. And you can also customize those. Okay, I can add a text, hello, whatever. Okay, and of course I can add attachment. So I can send some documents which are actually available within my PC. So if I just click on add attachment, I can, for example, add a Word document. Then I can add, a PNG file, for example. Okay, so whatever, I can mix and match different type of document. And then I can just click send to start the transaction. So this transaction will be queued to two different destinations. And as soon as there is an available resource, the fax will be sent out. And at the end of the transaction, I will receive back an email notification which say your fax has been successfully sent. Right. Okay, but now the most important feature, our Imagical Antenna Console. Here we go. All right, as mentioned before, this is just a client, okay? A client which is using the existing phone device that you're using. So in my case, the client is associated to my Microsoft Teams client, okay? So whatever I do here, when I start a call, when I answer a call, it will actually command this client. But don't forget that I can do exactly the same from a desk phone. So providing you're going to adopt our solution with desk phone by using Poly desk phone registered as a SIP device to Microsoft Teams, then we can actually use the same console for this purpose. Let me change the language because this is now in my home language, Italian, but of course I can change it to English, first of all. And as you can see on the fly, everything is changed to English, all the labels. But for our friends coming from the Middle East, I also have the possibility to change to Arabic. Here we go. So I got the magical antenna console already changed in Arabic language. Now, I'm sorry, but I'm not familiar that much with Arabic. So let me switch back to English. Here we go. Okay. Let me briefly explain what it's all about, this antenna console. Okay. So this is a 4-in-1 application. So first of all, it is a phone bar, which allows me to control my phone device. So from here, I can make a call, I can answer a call, I can hang up a call, I can set the call on hold and resume, I can transfer the call with or without consultation and supply transfer, and I can also trigger a conference call by inviting all the other parties and put them together into a conference call. Okay, that's the very first feature. Second feature, it is an agent bar. Okay, as you can see on top left, we got a lot of counters. So how many calls I served, how many calls I missed, average call duration, average answering time, how many calls are actually waiting into the queue in this right moment. Okay, these are counters which are updated in real time. And how many VIP calls are waiting into the queue. And I've got a max waiting time, which is a counter which can be useful to consult. I have a login logout button. So now it's green. So it means I'm logged in into the queue. But as you can see, I'm in pause. Okay. So this is a button that I can use if I need to go for a smoke, if I need to go to the toilet for a coffee break, or if I need to go out for lunch, for example. So I'm going to set myself in pause. And if a new call comes in into the queue, the call will be transferred maybe to another operator, which is available, which is on duty in this moment. Underneath this button, I have some specific panel. I have the queue panel. From here, I can see all the calls which are actually waiting to be served, which are in the queue, waiting for somebody to serve. So I have a panel which is showing all the queues, and I have a specific panel for my specific queue where I'm logged in, which is the demo customer service. Okay. So as soon as a new call comes in into the queue, it will appear a new line into this panel, and I can book the call. For example, if I know the person, I can book, or I can just wait for the algorithm, for the distribution algorithm, to transfer the call to me directly. Okay. I have also an agent panel which allows you to see who are the other agents which are included into the call and who are the agents which are actually logged in this moment into the queue. Right. The third feature that I want to explain to you is the supervisor. Okay. It happens that I am also a supervisor of this demo customer service queue. And in this case, I have also access to a third panel, which is the dashboard. Okay. This is a very important dashboard, which is showing all the KPI, all the performance counter related to your agent and the overall call center environment. Now, this panel is not very nice if you want to consult it directly from the attendant console, but we have the possibility to detach this panel from the main graphical interface and show it into a separate window. Now, this separate window, if you want, you can move it to another screen, for example, or you can simply enlarge to full screen mode. And here we go. Here we have a lot of information updated in real time for everything. So, you know, for each queue, we have how many calls served, how many calls abandoned, overflow, the average waiting time. We have the list of all the agents. And for each agent, we have a lot of counters. You know, that time in login state, how many calls have been served, how many missed, average answering time, etc. You know, important KPI. Okay. Don't forget that those information, if you're using the native attendant console from Microsoft, you won't get anything like that. And then for each and every agent in the queue, I have a separate panel which is showing me, you know, what he's doing, if he's logged in, if he's logged out, if he's in pause, and the relevant percentage, you know, how many calls has been served by each agent, how many calls has been missed by each agent. And once again, those information are updated in real time. Actually, we have several customers which are using this dashboard projected into a large LCD screen, like maybe, you know, 50 inches screen, okay, so that all the people in the call center room, they can see all those data updated in real time while the day goes on. Excellent. Okay, I was talking about four. One, okay, the missing one is the fourth. Okay, so this is the perfect companion for switchboard operator. You know, these are the operator, very busy operator, which are answering all the incoming call for the company. And then eventually they need to transfer the call to the colleagues, okay, depending on the request coming from the remote party. So it is very important for those switch operator to access, first of all, to the directory of the internal colleagues, the company colleagues, which is the colleague tab that I'm showing you. And you can, of course, search by name, you can search by extension, by department, call center. For example, I want to see only the colleagues from the dev department. I can just apply filter on top of this, and this is going to show me only those. Okay, but most important for all those contacts, I have a lot of information. So first of all, I have the telephony status. So I know upfront if the guy is on the phone or if he's available to answer a call. I have the present status coming from Microsoft Teams. You know, for Microsoft Teams, you can set yourself in a meeting, do not disturb, out for lunch, whatever. And those information are displayed in real time on the attendant console as well. Last but not least, we got the calendar information. So for each of my colleague, I can see all the appointment of the current day. Okay, so I will know upfront if he's available. If he is available now, or maybe he's available maybe in 1 hour or something like that, because I can actually browse his calendar. This is a feature that every user can decide to share or not share to the switcher operator. But you know, the switcher operator requests this type of information. It's very important for them, and we are providing directly into the internet console. And once again, this is updated real time. So if a new appointment is set, it will also appear into this icon. Other than internal contacts, the switcher operator can also have access to the directory of external contacts. So once again, I can search by name, surname, etc., and find external contact. And if I need to click and to call any of those, I can just click on the call icon and then trigger an outbound calls to any of those contacts. I do have a call registry, which is including all the calls that I have done, that I have received, okay, that I missed. And once again, for the registry, I have the possibility to call back any of those customers straight from the registry, a very quick way. Right, okay. Now I'm going to show you what is happening when I call the queue. Okay, please bear in mind that in the moment that I'm going to answer the call, there will be a blackout. So we will not hear anymore my voice, I'm afraid, because this is a WebEx session, but I'm answering from a Microsoft Teams client. The Microsoft Teams client is stealing the audio. Okay, you can imagine why. You know, Cisco and Microsoft, they're not very in good relationship. Okay, anyway, let me do a phone call from my mobile phone. Okay, you can hear an IVR. I press 1 now, and the call will be routed to the magical queue. Go. Okay, let me. Okay, now the call should arrive. Okay, sorry, let me do it again because probably. Okay, press 1. Here it is. Okay, now the call is in the queue and I can see the contact name, as you can see. There is my name and there is also my phone number. And now the call is coming to me and I have a pop-up which say call incoming call from Andres Sonnino. Now I'm going to answer the call from the time console. Second, I was not fast enough. Let's wait. Okay, gentlemen, I'm back. Sorry, I could not speak during the call, as I say. Anyway, I think you have seen by watching your video that okay, there was a call incoming call into the queue, and then I went to this call has been transferred to me, so it was appearing the same call into the current calls. And in that moment, I had the possibility to answer the call, so I just clicked on the answer call, the green button that was appearing here. And starting from that moment, I have full control of the conversation. So I can talk with the remote party by leveraging the Microsoft Teams client, which is providing the voice features, okay? Then later on, I can hang up the call by pressing on the red button here. I can set the call on pause and resume it. I can transfer with consultation. I can do a blind transfer, and I can create a conference call. As you probably notice, I also press this button here. This button here allows me to send an email. So actually during the conversation, I can click on this button. I can select a specific template which I can prepare upfront, and each operator can do that. And this template is including information about the current call, like the name, like the calling number. And what I need to do is just add a destination email address and then send it out. Okay, that's very, very useful. For example, if you're handling a booking for, I don't know, for in an hospital or something like that, and you want to send back a reminder via mail, this is the perfect solution for that. Great. You probably noticed that in the pop-up coming from the Microsoft Teams client, there was my name, okay? So not just the calling number. Again, this is a feature provided by our application, very important. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the demo. Now let's go back to the presentation for some remaining slides, a few more to go. Okay, this is a summary slide, which is summarizing all the different applications which are available in the Microsoft Teams environment. And as you can see, we have this applied distinction by PSTN access, okay? So local PSTN means that you're going to leverage a direct routing architecture with a local SBC and a local access to a local carrier. Or cloud PSTN, which means you're going to use Microsoft Teams with its own Microsoft dial plan and the access provided directly from Microsoft. So for that kind of console, whatever is the version, it's available for regardless of the PSTN access. Okay, we are still writing control the release, but it's actually available to general public. Control the release, why? Because the API that we are leveraging to control the phone, to control the routing, etc., are still in tuning phase by Microsoft. Okay, Microsoft is applying some modification here and there, etc., so they're not really consolidated. That's why we are still staying controlled release. Okay, but we're sure that probably within the end of this year there will be a stable release, and we are off. About advanced queuing and auto attendant, so the application for call queuing and the IVR application, both available regardless of the PSTN access. About call recording, this is general availability, okay? So by leveraging the Microsoft API, we can grant the recording of any call, inbound, outbound, internal, external, in always on mode, to any Microsoft Teams user, okay? And this is done. Digital fax is available, again, regardless of the PSTN access. Contact manager, so the possibility to access to the contact from the Magical Attendant console or from the Microsoft Teams client or from the web portal, no problem. For the call analytics, you know, our call accounting and billing application. Here we say yes only for the local PSTN. Why? That's very simple, because Microsoft nowadays is not providing good API to retrieve the CDRs for the calls directly from the Microsoft Teams cloud, okay? So we have to count on a local SBC, okay? So in this case, Call Analytics is available only for direct routing architecture with a local SBC. And we're going to retrieve the CDR directly from this local SBC. And nowadays we support both AudioCode SBC and Cisco Cube SBC. For these two, we can collect the CDRs, which are of course related only to PSTN call. So all the inbound and outbound external PSTN call can be fully documented by our application. For the native integration with the cloud Microsoft Teams, in order to document any type of call, so also internal call, we are waiting for this. But again, it will happen in a few months, and we are going to advertise this. Let me say that we already started the certification process to have the Magical UC Cloud Suite for Microsoft Teams certified by Microsoft, right? You can actually follow up the progress of the certification by going into this specific web page, which is available directly in the Microsoft website, okay? You will see that there are already some vendors which are already certified, and we are in under certification. Okay, but very soon we're going to be certified. Another news that I want to share with you is the possibility, starting from our next release, which is going to be the summer 2022, basically starting from July this year, so a few days from here, to synchronize your Microsoft Teams user directly from Azure AD. Very important, okay? So no need anymore to have a local Active Directory or maybe import from a CSV. No, we just connect to your Azure AD, and this is easy for us because Azure AD and the Magico UC Suite are both in the cloud. So it's a cloud-to-cloud transaction, and we're going to import all those contacts straight away. Okay. No need for on-premise infrastructure, no need for connector. Everything is going to be embedded into the Magico UC Cloud Suite, and it's free of charge, of course. Okay, great. Well, if you're interested to talk about commercial with our colleagues, with Anas, with Fauzi, and all our colleagues taking care of the European market, please ask, okay? So you can leverage this quad code that we are sharing here, and just contact us, and we're going to help you for whatever request. But at the same time, if you want to have a call with us, if you want to discuss any type of matter, you know, both commercial or technical matters, together maybe with myself, please leverage this quad code, and we are going to schedule a call with you, and we can discuss whatever you need, and we can also deliver a presentation to you. Third option, you have here our email address, so you can just drop us an email, and we'll be more than happy to answer to you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now it's your turn. If you have any question, please use the chat panel or use the Q&A panel, and I will be happy to answer to you. Anas, do you see any question?
Because thank you so much, Andrea. Great presentation, great insights. Let's see, I mean, if our attendees has any questions.
Okay, I see a nice comment coming from Ujival. He said he's very happy for this. Okay, Cloud BSTN, nice, but is it available in Saudi? Okay, Sultan, at the moment, it is not available, actually, okay? So if you want to leverage a Microsoft Teams environment, you still, for the moment, need to use direct routing. So you're going to have a local SBC connected to a local carrier, like STC or whatever you want. Let's see if there are other questions. Anas, please also check your chat because maybe some people are sending the question to you.
Yes, doing now.
Okay.
I don't have any over here.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, not a problem. If later on, by thinking a little bit more about what you've seen, you have some question, just send us an email or contact us via WebEx or via Teams, and we'll be more than happy to answer to your
questions. Andrea, quick question maybe our partners will be interested in is, what is required if they have a client and wants to make a POC? What we need from them?
Okay. In this case, we have a specific shared public instance available in our cloud, and we can just add the Microsoft Teams tenant in this shared instance, and we can allow you to test all the Magical application, right? That's not a big problem. So the Magical UC Cloud Suite is already there. It's just a matter of applying configuration on the Microsoft Teams tenant, you know, by accessing the Azure portal or the Microsoft 365 portal, and apply the configuration required. And we can test the tenant console, we can test the fax, whatever you want.
Perfect, that sounds great. So waiting for any requirements, any email, you can feel free to call us as well. We'll be always be happy to help you. We have a question, we'll just put you
yes.
In the question. Yes, integrations, but you can
yes,
see
I
it.
I can read it, yes, okay. No, we are delivering the Imagico UC Suite for Microsoft Teams only from our cloud. You cannot have an on-prem installation because don't forget, this is a cloud to cloud, okay? So the Imagico UC Cloud Suite in our cloud is natively available from internet, and you can natively communicate with Microsoft Teams through internet, okay? If you have an on-prem Imagico Suite, it's gonna be a nightmare because you need to open a lot of ports and it's really complicated. By having it in Imagico UC Cloud Suite, you have full access to the Microsoft Teams cloud. And moreover, all the user can leverage from anywhere, from home, from roaming, etc.
Thank you so much. Sounds clear and good. So let's take this forward with any cases you have. Feel free to contact us and we are here to help you. Thank you so much, Andrea.
Thank you. You will be asked to compile a very quick feedback form, okay? And just let us know what you think about it, and we'll be more than happy. Thank you so much, and have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Bye, Andrea.